Parliament has approved a proposal by the government to mainstream the Dairy Development Authority DDA into the Agriculture Ministry. This merger ended a five-month debacle that began with Parliament's initial rejection of the amendment bill. The stalemate prompted President Yoweri Museveni to meet the Agriculture Committee and later the National Resistance Movement NRM Parliamentary Caucus, where a consensus was struck. While tabling the report yesterday, Agnes Linda Auma, Lira District Woman MP on independent ticket, cautioned that DDA's rationalization could undermine the regulator's progress and negatively impact the market. Agriculture Minister Frank Tumwebaze defended the merger, arguing that the government believes that the ministry and its relevant departments can effectively integrate DDA's functions. The Dairy Industry Amendment Bill 2024 was tabled for first reading on September 24, 2024. It was then referred to the respective Committee of Parliament. Under the arrangement, the body's functions shall be mainstreamed into the Agriculture Ministry. Ten people were feared dead in a petrol fire tank at Chigogwa on the Matuga Bombo Road in Wakiso District. Eyewitnesses said several bodies were burnt beyond recognition when they were engulfed by the flames as they were trying to scoop fuel that was spilling from the fuel tank. The police firefighters rushed to Chigogwa town to respond to a fire that gutted a fuel tanker in the middle of the road, resulting in huge flames and smoke, bringing traffic to a standstill. According to Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson Patrick Onyango, a multi-agency response team swiftly responded to the scene, including fire brigade trucks, 4999 patrol cars, police ambulances, Red Cross ambulances, and sister security forces rushed to the scene. He said rescue efforts were, by press time, still underway. Onyango explained that the fire started at about 3 p.m. yesterday when the tanker overturned. Kenya's High Court on Tuesday began hearing a legal bid by impeached Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua to overturn his ouster in a political saga that has plunged the upper echelons of Kenyan politics into disarray. But both he and President William Ruto challenged for different reasons the court's ability to hear the case.
There is an application here.
In a fast-moving and sometimes confusing drama, the High Court in Nairobi on Friday ordered that Gachagua's impeachment be put on hold. Its ruling came just minutes after Parliament had approved Interior Minister Githure Kindiki to replace Gachagua as Ruto's deputy. Gachagua was impeached by the Senate on Thursday on 5 out of 11 charges against him. The embattled 59-year-old has denied all the allegations, and his legal team swiftly launched an appeal alleging the process had been unfair and rushed. His legal team, however, challenged the makeup of the three-judge bench, protesting that it had not been constituted by Kenya's Chief Justice Martha Koome, but by her deputy.